SOLIDWORKS 2020 is nearly here, and over the next month or so, we'll be diving into the different areas of the software to bring you the details on all the latest enhancements. However, as SOLIDWORKS is such a broad package, a lot of these new additions may not be relevant to the entire user base, so in this video, I'm going to give you my breakdown on what I feel are the best improvements for anyone modeling in SOLIDWORKS. So, in no particular order, let's start with enhancement number one. When opening SOLIDWORKS assemblies, there's always been the option to control how much model information you want to load. Though now, a new slider clearly shows the level of detail being opened, along with the available options. Large Design Review Edit Mode is the fastest way to make changes to a complex assembly, and it's received further enhancements since being introduced last year. Previously in Edit Mode, you could add, delete, and move components and mates, and change parts configurations. SOLIDWORKS 2020 adds the ability to mate to reference geometry contained inside components, such as planes, create and edit component patterns, and it also adds several usability improvements, such as copy and paste, drag and drop inserts, and using Tab and Shift Tab to hide and show components. For SOLIDWORKS 2020, performance has been improved all around in drawings, as graphics acceleration is now available. And a specific new editing mode has been added. Detailing mode allows you to open massive drawings in seconds, because it doesn't load the model, though all the existing drawing views and annotations are still available for detailing. While in detailing mode, you can rearrange views, add dimensions, add annotations such as center marks or balloons, print the drawing, save as a PDF, and more. All in all, this should be a great time-saving mode for anyone working on large drawings. A couple of notes to remember if you're going to try this out. First, detailing mode will only appear as an option if you've already opened and saved a drawing in SOLIDWORKS 2020, and secondly, if you ever need to load the full drawing at any point, you don't need to close it and reopen it to get out of the mode, simply right-click in the tree and choose to resolve the drawing. While improving performance and usability is a goal for every release of SOLIDWORKS, it's really been a major focus this year, so my third new feature is actually a collection of all the interface tweaks made across the software. When working on drawings, it's easier than ever to input custom drawing scales through several new areas in the interface. Tooltips have been enhanced throughout to give more information, and some even contain example animations. Using folders to organize your tree is easier than ever, as you can now drag consecutive features into a folder. And a search bar has been added to the materials panel to save time. Finally, as a big fan of shortcuts, this is my highlight, there has been several improvements made to QuickMates. The QuickMate toolbar appears whenever you select multiple components in an assembly, and with SOLIDWORKS 2020, you can now flip the mate alignment after adding a QuickMate, control the parameters of a width mate, add limit distance and limit angle mates, and more. Creating smooth curvature is very important for many modern designs. And there are hundreds of examples I could give of consumer products that feature a blend that is smoother and more complicated than a simple radial fillet. It's honestly too deep a topic to get into outside of a training environment. But to sum up the improvement, SOLIDWORKS is now capable of creating smoother curves than ever in sketches, thanks to the new G3 sketch relation. Convert Entities is an invaluable tool for many designers. It allows you to project edges into your current sketch to easily reuse geometry and new features. However, it is limited to converting edges or faces. Silhoutte Entities is new to 2020, and essentially it functions the same, but instead it allows you to select entire bodies or parts. Here I want to create an indent in this packaging for the watch to rest in. So, after beginning a sketch, I can access Silhoutte Entities from beneath Convert Entities, and with a single click on the watch, the whole part is selected. External silhouette is selected, so no interior sketch loops will be created as I OK the command. I want this cut to be slightly larger, so I'll offset the edges and then use a cut extrude to create that small cut into the packaging foam. This looks like it's worked well, so the final thing for me to do is to mate the watch in position. One small extra tip for this, if you're trying to use silhouette entities inside an assembly and you only want to pick up on a body within a part rather than the whole part, you can turn on the body filter down here and that'll just change your selection, allowing you to be more specific with what you're after. Surface offset has been improved so that the command can now complete even if your selection contains faces that can't be offset. Instead, these faces are highlighted and you can remove all failing faces easily with a right click. Any gaps or problem areas can then be plugged with regular surfacing tools. This one I see as being a huge time saver for anyone that uses surfacing. Flexible components are new to 2020, and they provide a perfect method of representing springs, cables, living hinges, and other flexible parts in multiple states within an assembly, without needing to create any extra configurations. This not only saves time, but it also helps you to keep an accurate BOM. Making a component flexible is easy. Simply select the command from the context menu, and then choose a new target for the part's external references. This part's 3D path will now update to follow the new circular face reference. Every time the assembly now moves, the parts will update. My last pick is a small change, but I feel it's likely to benefit every user. Sometimes when design changes are made, subsequent fillets will fail due to losing their edge references. In this example, the cutout needs to be split into a separate feature so that it can support multiple configurations. After making this change, however, the fillets fail, despite their position remaining the same. With fillet repair, we no longer need to reselect the edges, and instead, we can simply edit the feature, right-click, and choose to repair all missing edges. So that brings us to the end of my picks. I hope you can see how these are going to save you time, though this is only a fraction of what's new to SOLIDWORKS 2020. If you do want to learn more, please check back regularly for new videos, or consider attending one of our regional SOLIDWORKS 2020 launch events.